Look at that hair. I look like Kramer. Oh man. All right, welcome back to another video. This is probably the first time you're seeing us in the new studio here on YouTube with it all set up. If you are following us on Instagram, you will see that we've made quite a bit of progress in the last year. I will make another video dedicated to the new studio build. In this video, we're talking about the probe lens. It is probably the most unique lens I've ever used. Let's jump in. So this is the case that it comes in. It is pretty over the top, but the lens is very long, so it does make sense that it would require some sort of case like this. So when you open it up, the probe lens obviously takes up most of the space. It also comes with some cables. And then I've cut out into the foam a place to keep this little USB charger. And that's because this lens actually comes with a light that allows you to get some really incredible shots. By nature, because this is a macro lens, you really want to get this as close as you can to the subject that you're filming. And therefore that light really, really does come in handy. So it comes with two cables. One is just a generic sort of USB cable. And the other one comes with a control where you can increase or decrease the brightness of the light on the front. This is an f/14 lens. That means the aperture can only open up to f/14. Filming outside on a bright day is no problem, but when you're inside, you definitely need to have controlled lighting, and that's when the ND light really comes in, but that's only gonna get you so far. With the ND light, you can light up within a few inches, I'd say, the subject you're filming, but anything in the background or around it is just gonna be completely dark. And that's where you really need to turn on some additional lighting to be able to control your scene and get the best lighting for your shot. It is a really strange looking lens. I don't think there's anything else in the market that even remotely looks like this. To have this really long barrel at the front, but by design that means you can place the front of this into tight spaces like in a backpack or a bag of chips like I did, and the results are really something that you can only get with this lens. Now, this is also a 24 mil, so it is quite wide. Before this, I had a 100 mil macro Canon lens, which obviously is very telephoto. This is a 2:1 when focused to the closest position, which means things will be twice the magnification. One thing that really blew me away with this lens was how close you can focus on things. With the 100 mil macro, you have to be at least, I would say, a few inches away from the subject, but on the probe lens, you can basically touch your subject on the front and you can still get focus. I grabbed one of our Aperture MC lights and I held it really close to the end, and you could see the threading holes, or the threading I should say, on the inside of the mounting hole. That's such a tiny area, but to see it magnified, especially if you're watching back on a big screen in 4K. One of the first shots that I set up was I set the probe lens up on my slider. I own the 5-foot long Kessler CineSlider. I sat in front of it and then slowly pulled it toward my left eye. It's unbelievable how close you can get, because you can get such good detail. Or here's another shot where I was able to rack focus between my eye and eyelashes. And of course that means we're racking focus between millimeters. Because it's just a really awkward long lens, it means that you have to be very specific with the type of shots you're getting, and you need to plan ahead and set up the lighting, set up the environment, and then pretty much only then you'd be set up and ready to go. Another great feature is the fact that the entire front barrel of this lens is waterproof. That means you can dunk the end of the lens right into liquid without worrying about it getting damaged. Would I recommend this lens to everybody? I would say no. The reason is, because it has such a specific use case, close-up macro type footage, it doesn't really come in handy in any other scenario. And because it's such an expensive lens, you know, upwards of $2,000+, there are definitely a whole bunch of lenses that would come way more in handy than this. But if there is a certain shot you need that's super close up, or there's not a lot of space to fit a regular type lens into, this might be your only option. And also, if you're traveling, for example, are you really gonna bring this lens around? Probably not, because it's big, it takes up a lot of space with the case, and I think it would be pretty fragile. You know, if it was placed in a bag and there was some pressure on the middle, I would be afraid of that causing damage to the lens. And a word of advice, because you can focus so close to the end, Be very, very careful where you position the camera and where you're moving the camera. I've come so close to hitting the front lens glass off what I was filming. Definitely a word of caution, be very careful. All right, so that does it for this video on the review of the Probe Lens. I had a lot of fun using it, and if you can get your hands on it, I definitely suggest you try it out because you can get super creative and get a lot of cool shots with this. I would definitely recommend at some point trying to get your hands on one of these, especially for like a demo reel, if you're building out, you know, a show reel for yourself to get work. Using this could help your footage get noticed because the footage you can get with this really does stand out. All right, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel to see more videos from us. We have over 100 filmmaking tutorials on this channel, so if you're into it, check those out as well. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.